everyone. Thank you for coming up today. My old subscribers, thank you. And to those that are viewing for the first time or that have not subscribed, please click on the subscribe button and the notification bell so you get notified each time we upload a new video. And to my new subscribers, thank you for subscribing. Please do not forget to hit on the like button. A very big tragedy has just struck a family. This is an event that no one would wish their family member. It was actually gathered that this guy you can see there, he's called Solomon, alongside with his father, Amadou Solomon, and five other people, they all embarked on a journey. It's just so painful to hear that on this trip that this family, father and his son and these other people embarked at the Gazabu village in Bali local government area of Taraba State in Nigeria. While they were on their way to this trip, unfortunately, they got involved in a very terrible accident. The 18-seater Hummer bus conveying the people that went to Besa, the headquarters of Kumi local government area of Taraba State, all for a funeral of one late Kume Ndola, which was held on Friday. And they were all coming back from this funeral that they went for. Just so sad to announce that the tire of this bus that was moving just busted, which made the vehicle lose control and it somersaulted several times. Imagine an 18-seater bus somersaulting with people. What would happen in the end? It was just so painful that six people died on the spot while several others sustained varying degrees of injuries. The most painful one out of this accident is the father, Solomon and Amadou, both of them died at a spot in this particular horrific accident. It was just six people, and out of the six, two people from one family, that is whom you can see in that photo, didn't survive this accident. It's a very sad one for their family. You can imagine that this young man that you're seeing there, see all the struggle, all his efforts to come out of law school, in the end, this is what has befallen him and his father. Meanwhile, his friends and classmates have taken to their social media to mourn this young man and his father. One of his friends, who is called Megida Dogonyaru, said that they had discussed about their life after graduation. See how painful life can be. After all their struggle, you know, friends will always sit down and start planning life ahead, even though we know that man proposes and God disposes. But at the same time, as humans, it's always good to plan your life ahead while you pray and ask God to intervene into those plans. That was exactly what this guy and his friend was planning. These were the exact words that came from his own friend. I remember when you were chatting and discussing about our life after graduation. You even promised to come to Gesheka with your own personal car during my wedding, because we categorically agreed that we will hustle and gather resources before our law school. You even told me that after graduation, you will enhance your banana and palm tree plantation at Ndaforo Kumi local government area. We are only left with 1 month to graduate, just for me to hear that you engaged in a motor accident and you died instantly. What a gruesome accident. What a gruesome death. Death, why? You took away a vibrant potential counsel, a young lawyer in the making, full of intellectual momentum and colossus. What a great loss, 500 level student. What a great loss, Faculty of Law, Taraba State University. What a great loss, in tutor. What a great loss to incoming generation. I am in dark gloom and deep depression. These were the exact words that his friend Megiddo Samson Dogonyaro had written down on his Facebook page. A lot of people paying tribute to him. A friend wrote again, "Our hearts are broken forever. People tell us that in time, the pieces will eventually come back together. If this is true, though hard to believe now, there will always be a space, the peace to which has your heart." It's just a very painful and sad incident. And it's so painful because both the father and the son lost their lives out of all of the people that were in this tragic accident. Sad again, a lot of them sustained varying degrees of injuries. They are at the hospital right now receiving treatment. Thank God that they survived. We pray for healings upon them. But you can imagine that this young man, full of life, with his dad, unknown to them that going for a funeral will end their own life. Sometimes they say when you go to bury people, and then in the course of burying these people, either on your way to the venue or on your way back, people die. They would now say, in some part of Africa, they would now say that the people you went to bury have taken lives along with them, that they don't want to go down alone. Well, sometimes this could also be seen as some superstitious beliefs, but in some location they still hold on to it. It's so sad. Imagine that you went for someone's funeral to bury someone, and in the end, those same people who went for this burial will now end up being the people that they would now bury again. Very, very painful death. See how death has swept this young man, his father, and these other four people, all six of them, away in one day. It's just so sad. That's another terrible thing about an accident. And theirs is a very bad one because the tires busted. I know if tires bust, it only takes the grace of God for people to survive the accident. But right now, in their own case, it was just a tragic one that it lost control. And you know, when people somersault in vehicle like that in an accident, it's difficult to have survivors. And that is why you find out that six of them all died instantly, while the others are having very serious injuries, which we hope and pray that they all get treated and well again. May the soul of Solomon and his dad Amadu and all the other four people that died rest in peace with the Lord. May Almighty God console their entire family, friends, well-wishers, everyone that knew them. May Almighty God console them all. It's really a very difficult moment for their family because now they are mourning two people in one family. That is a very tragic one. This is not anything anyone will wish for their family members. That's why it's always good for people to be very prayerful. When you embark on a journey and you come back safely, you need to thank God because it's not your grace. A lot of people travel, leave their houses, and they never come back again. It's just the grace of God that's protecting each and every one that travels and comes back in one peace, just as you left the house. Once again, may their souls rest in peace and may God console their various families. It's just a very tragic loss. Friends, please, if you have anything to say, you could put that down at the comment section. Thank you for coming up today. Please don't forget to hit on the like button. Also, subscribe and hit the notification bell so you get notified each time we upload a new video. Thank you. God bless you all.